All right. So just like with de minimis rules of origin under the general note 12 under the HTSUS for NAFTA, NAFTA marking also has de minimis definitions, and they're available under 102.13. And just like under the general note 12 HTSUS, you also see that 7% rule, right? And that 7% rule is applicable to value if it is non-textiles, and weight if it is a textile or apparel product. So your knowledge from general note 12 is portable or almost portable, we shall see why I say almost, into the NAFTA marking rules. Let's see how this how examiners test you on this topic. So except for foreign materials incorporated into the good under HTS, so those are the exceptions, we'll get to them. Materials that do not go applicable change in tariff classification or satisfy any applicable requirement under the rules of origin when incorporated, they can be disregarded. And the only reason they can be disregarded is because of that de minimis requirement, right? If the country of origin of the good, of the country of origin, if, and you have this 7 and 10% rule, right? Let's take a look. The value of those materials is no more than 7% of the value. All right. If it's non-textile, right? Because we have except for those or except for textiles, it's 7% rule. So the examiners are testing you on the general rule, on rules of general applicability. So the key buzzwords here is the value and 7%. So A is correct. The value of those materials is more than 7% of the value of the good? No. There are exceptions, but we are talking about the general rule here. The value of those materials is more than 10%. Well, of the good of chapter 22, we'll see that there is a special provision for chapter 22, right? It is 10% rule, but it's actually 10% or less, not 10% or more. So C is not correct. The total weight of those materials is not more. So weight is applicable to textiles, right? And here we know that we're not talking about textiles because customs examiners explicitly excluded textiles from the fact pattern. So D is not correct. And E, the value of all foreign materials is no more than 7% of the value of the good, right? All foreign materials, right, is really not the best answer because we're talking about those materials, right? Those materials were the exception, right? So this one and this one really involves the best answer rule analysis. And here the value of all foreign materials no more than 7% of the value of the good can be applicable, right? But see, it is not a good continuation of the sentence. Because let's take a look at the sentence again. Except, and they list exceptions, foreign materials that do not go applicable change in tariff classification when incorporated the goods shall be disregarded. So see, the way customs examiners, the way they're implying that E is not correct answer is all foreign materials, right? What if some of the materials do go applicable change in tariff classification? If they go through the applicable change in tariff classification, then they're fine under the general note 12T. So de minimis portion is not applicable, right? Or if we're talking about marking, same thing. Here, it's not all foreign materials, but only those materials that do not undergo the applicable change. Those here is really the key point here, the key word, because it makes a good continuation from, it makes a good slide in implication that we're talking about only the materials that do not undergo the applicable tariff shift. This is the reason why A is the best answer choice here. So while B, C, and D can be excluded, E and E is the biggest struggle point here. And here you really have to kind of understand that those refers to those ones that do not go change in tariff classification. And of course, if they are testing on de minimis, and by default they do not go to, they are not referring to the those foreign materials that changed due to tariff shifting, making this answer also incorrect answer choice under this question.